unless you think I'm overdressed, this is my slip. I got a figure that just won't starch. My body's in such bad shape, I wear prescription underwear. I finally had a ship tattooed on my chest. I wanted something on it. Would you believe that I once entered a beauty contest? I must have been out of my mind. I not only came in last, I got 361 get well cards. I don't want you to get the idea that I have given up on my looks. I will never give up. I am in my 14th year of a 10-day beauty plan. When I go to bed at night, I've got so much grease on my body, I wear snow chains to hold up my gown. We've got more grease stains in the bedroom than we got in the garage. One night, I asked Fang to kiss me goodnight. He got up and put on his work clothes. You know, the lights have gone out, but dirty old Fang. The last time there was a gleam in Fang's eye, there was a short in his electric blanket. All he cares about is football. I thought that our weekends after we were married would be a loaf of bread, a jug of wine, and love. You know how it turned out? A box of pretzels, a can of beer, and the Green Bay Packers. You wouldn't believe the way this man boozes. He can kill a six-pack during an instant replay. His breath is so bad, the dentist works on him through his ears. He's such a coward, when I take him to the dentist's office, they have to strap him in the chair, give him a shot of Novocaine, and a balloon. That's in the waiting room. I only know one coward worse than Fang, and that's our watchdog, Rin Tin Dum Dum. Who ever heard of a German shepherd who bites his nails? He barks with a lisp. You say attack, and he has one. He's nothing but a fur-covered chicken. Fang went at him with a gun. He laid an egg. The only thing smart about the dog, whenever I say heel, he goes straight over to Fang. We had a thunderstorm, the stupid dog hid in the oven. It was lit. It's the first time Fang ever complimented me on something I was cooking. I admit, I've got to be the world's worst cook. My mother taught me nothing. She said, if it turns black, it's a roast. If it falls, it's a cake. She was a complete dingamite. She used to sit in the kitchen and kill flies with a hammer. The house is a mess, I admit it. We live in the only house in America ever fired on by welcome wagon. Fang couldn't care less. He's so out of it. He's as happy as a Cuban with a new airplane. You've got to hand it to that silly Castro. He took a little teeny country like Cuba and made it into the world's largest airport. Three ways to go now. Tourist, first class, prisoner. I was at a ticket counter the other day and a guy rushed up and said, I'll take two chances on Miami. And everybody on the airlines are so chumpy. I got up to go to the galley one day and the whole crew surrendered. Of course, the last time I flew was when I went to visit Jackie Onassis. She's a big literary figure now. She married the old man in the sea. You know, it's a terrible thing to visit Jackie and see all those riches and then come home to Fang. It's like having a proposal of marriage from Paul Newman the day after you married Tiny Tim. And of course, Fang was never any help with the kids. When we were having our first kid, I woke him up in the middle of the night to tell him I felt life. He thought I was sleeping on a magazine. I told him, why don't you buy a book and find out what is going on here? Of course, he's too cheap to spend any money. He's still got money. The tooth fairy left him. One time I went to the doctor and he told me that what I needed was an ocean breeze. Fang fanned me with a herring. Christmas, he buys one Christmas card and sends it out as a chain letter. Then all during the Christmas holidays, he talks with a Jewish accent. Christmas Eve, he fires one shot, puts the kids to bed, and tells them Santa committed suicide.